we should not just stay at concepts and teachings. I think more important at this point is a methodology. How do we connect observation with analysis and reflection leading to action? Now, you can imagine Catholic social teaching as principles, Catholic social teachings as methodology, Catholic social teaching as spirituality. Now, at this point, what I'd like to do is to invite you to sharpen our capacity to do analysis. And that's part of reading the signs of the times. Meron na tinatawag ng pastoral circle. And it stems from Gojo Express. Sabi niya, the joys and the hopes, the griefs and anxieties of the men and women of this age, especially those who are in any way poor or in any way afflicted. These are the joys and hopes, the griefs and anxieties of the followers of Christ. Now, what does it mean? Kung ano raw yung pinagdadaanan, ang nangyayari sa mga tao, lalong-lalo na yung mga biktima ng sitwasyon. Yung mga nasasaktan, yung mga umiiyak, yung mga naisasaktan ng lipunan. Ito ang mga gisalikway, gisiko-siko, gilabay-labayan, gibiay-biayan. Mga mayok-mok, mga kinasikat-sikara sa daon, ginaw-daon, mga itamas-tamasa, ginagaparo, ginakulata sa lingunan. Pero at the same time, ito po nila ang mga kalipay. Ang mga pinagdadaanan daw, yung mga hirap at saya ng mga tao sa mundo ngayon, lalong-lalo na yung mga naiipit, na isasangtabi, na ma-marginalized, dapat kaugat tayo doon. Yung mga sumusunod kay Kristo, dapat kakabit tayo ng buhay nila. So, in other words, the followers of Christ should be looking at, feeling with, and working in solidarity with those who have experiences of pain, those who have experiences of joy, but especially the poor. We should be there. We should be close to them. We should not be detached from them. Because the church is in the world. And why is the church in the world? Because the Lord came into this world. So we are not out of this world. We cannot have a religion that is only interested in the soul to be brought to heaven. Because the Lord came here to meet us as human beings. Hindi po pwede na naman, what is the role of religion? To save the soul and bring the soul to heaven. Hindi ganyan. Ano sa man to? Para ba yung soul eh, nasa loob, tapos lalagyan mo ng straw? Our religion is not just interested in the soul. Our religion, our God, is interested in the whole human being and in humanity and the world. God so loved the world that
whoever believes
will have eternal life. And I have come to bring life and life to the full. So, it is a fake religion. Meron fake news, meron fake religion. If your religion is interested only in souls, not interested in bodies, not interested in families, in societies, in the land, in work, in the field of science and technology. God did not create the land which is not important. No. Hindi po pwede. Hindi ganun ang Christianity. Kaya nga, nag-incarnate. When God became human flesh, and the Word was made flesh, earthly and earthy, it's because the Lord was also interested in what's going on in the world. So, pero when you look around, okay, people are interested. They play, they pray, they travel. Some of them have to go around, go to another country to find jobs. The Lord is interested in what happens to them. Some people are sick. The Lord is interested in healing them. Some people are just growing up. The Lord is interested in how you're going to form them. Some people are, pregnant. Some people are getting married. Some people are dying. The Lord is interested in them. Some mountains are denuded. Some trees are being cut off. Some lands are being destroyed. Some environments are being suffering from disasters and hazards. The Lord is interested in them. And if the Lord is interested in them, then the followers of the Lord should be interested in them as well. Because the joys and the hopes, the griefs and anxieties of the men and women of these days, especially those who are suffering, those who are marginalized, those who are left out, should also be the concerns of the followers of Christ. Now, this leads to halagar bayon. Therefore, I should know what's going on. Therefore, I should know what's going on. Because the Lord is interested in it. Lalo na if we are putting up institutions. Therefore, I should be interested. Hindi po pwede yun. Basta ako, katikesti ko lang yung trabaho ko. So, sabi nga ni San Peter Henry, surely, if there is no church in the modern world, if there is not a Christian community composed of women and men, united in Christ, led by the Holy Spirit, then a journey to the kingdom intimately linked with humankind and its history in pilgrimage in time. So, pagdating niyan, in today's complex situation, the church, social doctrine, has become a fundamental guideline, offering approaches that are valid even beyond the confines of the institutional church. These guidelines need to be addressed in the context of dialogue with all those seriously concerned for humanity and for the world in which we live. Sabi ni Pope Benedict. So now we have guidelines on how to deal with the world, but in dealing with the world, we will also encounter people of different ideologies, different religions. Some of them do not have religions, but they are concerned with the environment, they are concerned with nutrition, they are concerned with pollution, they are concerned with what's going on in the corals, in the fishes, they are concerned with prices, they are concerned with oil, they are concerned with outer space, we should also be concerned with that. Now, some people, kahit na walang Diyos, you know, meron ding no Buddhist, pagka may disaster, you know what you'd see? Tulong sila doon. So they are concerned. That should be our concern as well. Like again, some Buanga scenes, 10,000 houses burned. I was there. So I'm witness to people flocking. Makita mo, galing sa ibang bansa, Germany, Australia, nagbibigay ng tulong. Red Cross, Christian Aid, Campol, tumutulong sila. Why? Because we are all part of humanity. And Christians should not shy away from that. So, important. Now, the social doctrine, the social teaching of the church can offer some guidelines on how to deal with the environment, how to deal with labor, with forced migration, with OFW situation, with the running of the state, with elections, etc. So sana meron ding kasama sa catechesis how to vote wisely. No? Or some of kuminsan, go further than that, encourage some people, some of our students, to run for office when they grow up. Not because of ambition, but because some people will have to hold power in society. We will need directors of agencies. We will need judges. We will need mayors. We will need vice mayors. We will need counselors. We need to encourage them to take their role in running this government, this country. Pero madalas wala yun, hindi na pag-usapan. So kung ano man yung nangyari sa kanal, sa imbornal, sa landslides, sa mga kalsada, sa mga checkpoints, sa mga gyera, mayroong biktima, dapat concerned yan ang mga naniniwala sa Panginoon. Kaya na siya pumunta dito eh, dahil concerned siya. Tapos, kung tayo hindi tayo concerned. Okay? Now, justice is both the aim and the intrinsic criterion of all politics. Here, politics and faith meet. It's Catholic social doctrine. The aim is simply to help purify reason and to contribute here and now, not just in the second coming, to the acknowledgement and attainment of what is just. So, anong sabihin nun? We have to work for justice. And therefore, we have to deal with politics, with economics. Ang good natin sabihin na, economics is not part of my catechesis. That's not part of catechesis. Nakain ka eh. Politics should be part of our catechesis. We have to prepare and encourage people to later on desire to serve the country as leaders. Sino dito nakapag-encourage na? What's your vision? To become a doctor. Good. What will you do? I will go abroad and help my parents. Good! Why not add one more sentence? You know, if you want to become a doctor, you want to help, you can be the regional director of the Department of Health. Because we need good doctors to run our Department of Health. At least one sentence, we have already infused concern for running good governance in the country. Hindi yung to go abroad, tapos magpunas ng puwit ng mga ibang tao, caregiver, wow, mag-graduate natin, oh, nakapag-abroad na. Caregiver pala. Hindi naman sa minamasama natin, pero sana mag-abroad tayo as tourists, as consultants, as guests. Sino dito ang encourage mo sa dyante? You can be an environmental scientist. Why not study weather because of climate change? Who would like to be a water engineer? Basta may tubig. Basta bahala na kung sino mag-aasikaso sa tubig. Hindi gano'n. Pero politics, in some degree, should be inculcated in our catechesis. Politics is ethics applied to the common good. Politics is ethics multiplied. Di ba? Hingi ka ng donation para makapagtayo ng bahay ng gawat kalinga. Eh kung inaayos ba naman yung budget ng National Housing Authority, sana mas maraming bahay. Oo So, may pakialam. In other words, ang Kristiyano may pakialam sa nangyayari sa mundo. Dahil ang Diyos mismo nakialam. Nung pumunta siya sa lupa, hindi lang siya para kantahan ng ano, sa island. Eh, kaya nga eh! Hindi yung pa-cute lang ng Diyos sa ilalim ng Christmas tree. Anyway. So, what I'd like to present here would be part of the Catholic social teaching is the methodology of being concerned, observing what is happening in the world, and moving towards action. So, yun ang tinatawag na, ano, yung sa pastoral circle. Ibilisan ko lang ito, umumpisa, background 1980, tapos ulitin ko ito sa ibang paraan. Nagkaroon ang tinatawag na pastoral circle, engaging reality, local situation, experience, ang alam nito ay si Judge Act. Napatandaan niya. Sino niya si Judge Act? Galing niya doon sa Second Vatican Council. No? Social, from social principles to practice. So what do you do? One, reviews the concrete situation. For example, in your parish, how many are malnourished? Is that part of our observation? Baka hindi. Then we are not concerned with it. Ilan ang teenage pregnancy? And what is the trend? Ilan ang drug addicts? Baka mas alam natin ilan yung kandila sa altar. Pag bumili ka ng kandila, alam mo. Hindi, alam ko. Ito yan, ganyan. Pero hindi natin alam. Ilan yung teenage pregnancy? Ilan yung suicide? Ilan ang kalye na sira? Well, yun na nga. Ang problema, we relegate this social concern only to the social action. That is our problem. Problem, kayo na bahala dyan na sa social action. Problema, yung social action, kalaban nila yung mga parokyano natin. Kasi hindi na itinuturo yung social teaching. Okay. So, review the concrete situation, then form a judgment on it in the light of the principles, and then we decide what in the circumstances can and should be done to implement these principles. So, see, judge, see, and then you judge that it is wrong, it is right, and then what do you do? Okay? Now, expanding yan, experience, judgment, reflection, and action. It's a circle, and it's also a cycle. I'll explain it later. So, don't say experience. You ask questions like, what is happening here? For example, if you think here, to me in the parish, so how many people do we have in the parish? How many are poor? How many are very poor? Well, how do you know that, Father? Well, how many are enrolled in 4Ps? Then you know. Ilan ba yung enrolled sa 4Ps? For all you know, some of the volunteers in the parish, some of them might be enrolled in the 4Ps. Hindi natin alam. Doon nagsimula yung gawad kalinga, yung sa Couples for Christ. Sabi nila, o sige, Couples for Christ, prayer session tayo, ha? O sharing, Bible sharing. O sunod sa bahay mo, ha? Sunod sa bahay niya. Tapos yung isa sabi, pwede mo huwag nalang sa bahay na. Bakit? Wala akong bahay. Teka, isang panaking natira. Nakikita na lang mo, punta tayo doon. And then they realized, many members of the Couples for Christ did not have decent homes. They are easily removed. So they said, maybe we should form a housing program. Doon yung simulang gawad. Kasi paibot-ibot sila, sharing. Then they realize, maganda na yung liturgy nila, wala pa lang bahay yung, yung mga members. Diba? Meron pang housing project para sa mga katikista. Sana. That would be a good project. Medyo sabihin mo para, eh, catechesis naman to, hindi naman to social action. Eh, yung catechesis mo nga walang bahay. So, hindi po pwede na, ano, yung hiwain mo lang yan. So, ito mo, another data. So, anong tanong mo? What is happening here? What are people here undergoing? I mean, how, what are the experiences of the people here? What are they feeling about these experiences? What stories are they telling? How are they responding to the situation? So that is practically a summary of the question, what is happening here? Don't worry. Some of you should be cheating right now. I give you handouts. So some of you should actually be looking. But I'll explain it later. Number two, reflection. What does it mean? And then action. What do we do now? I will explain this more in more detail later. Now, that was a summary. Para mabilis na si Jess. At now, later on, it was expanded into a pastoral circle. Now, see, this is the structure of St. John's Act. See, you observe what is happening. Judge, you can say, this is unchristian, this is acceptable, this is unacceptable. Therefore, we have to do something. Okay? Parang, simple. Very good. Very good. Yung iba, sabihin, o sige, see, or exposure time. Let's go to the farthest end of the parish, the poorest end of the parish, and then we pray over it, sabihin, oh, this is not according to the dignity of the human of human beings. Then, maybe we should do something about the poor. Maybe we should do something about the illiterate. Maybe we should do something about the unchurched. Yung mga nahihiyang pumasok sa simbahan. E ba paano yung mga gay? Paano yung mga hindi kasal? Paano yung mga single parent? Paano yung mga teenage
pregnant?
Na nag-uusap, pregnant. O paano yung mga bayot? Na sinasantabi, binubungbog ng parents. Paano yan? O paano yung mga hiwalay sa asawa? Paano yung, ilan ba yung nasa abroad? Ang tatay o nanay, tapos yung mga anak na pabayaan. Ilan ba yung nagsuswisite? Last week, I was in, ano, Ateneo de Manila, law school, sa Tagaytay. We gave a seminar to the student leaders of the Ateneo law school students. And one was crying because her best friend committed suicide. In Ateneo de Manila campus, my mom suicide. It's about teacher. Now, apparently, it's not just Japanese who are committing suicide. What, I don't know, yeah, yeah. Pressure, what's happening? So, you can say, that is un-Christian, that is unacceptable, we should do something. What about bullying in school? We should do something to the bully. We should do something to the bully. We should call the parents of the bully, etc. Okay? Now, at a certain point in the 1970s and 80s, they expanded the Sea Judge Act into what we call the pastoral circle. Instead of just see, well, experience and analyze. You analyze carefully what you see. And then you reflect, and then you act. I'll explain this further. So, reading circle, let's say, from experience, you analyze, and then you reflect, you pray over it, and then you act. Your action will produce a new set of experiences. Now, based on your action, what's the effect? Has it really improved the lives of the poor? Has it really made the out-of-school youth more welcome in the church? If not, maybe we should analyze it again and then improve. Okay? Now, it is called a circle because it looks like a circle, but actually, it can also be seen as a spiral. Why spiral? You observe, experience, you do analysis, and then theological reflection, pastoral planning leading to action, and then you evaluate your action, leading to new situation. A new situation. Halimbawa, biglang nagkaroon ng bagyo, talagang baha. All of a sudden, the government needs a land for rehabilitating the victims of disaster. All of a sudden, you have 10,000 people, newcomers to your parish. What did? Okay, you visit them, you consult them, you listen to them, you analyze their situation, how many of them are capable as farmers, as carpenters, as cooks, as lavandera. Then you say, ang pangit naman, ang liliit naman ang bahay. Then you sasabihin mo, that is untenable. Pastoral planning, we have to see the mayor and complain to the DSWD, leading probably to bigger houses. Now, their problem is different. You analyze it again. Okay. So, the circle actually is a spiral. Because the result of your action is not just going back to the same situation. Your intervention, our intervention, leads to a new situation. History. Now, what I'd like to do is to make it a little bit more detailed. Now, I have adopted it, and I call it there. Apat pa rin. Pero yung una ay data, instead of just experience. Analysis, reflection, and engagement. D-A-R-E, there. So, simple lang. Bakit data? Some people engage in action without even collecting, gathering data. Now, take note. If you do something, mag-action ka, halimbawa, you want to increase scholarship for the marginalized groups in the school. Okay, let's give 5 slots per year. Okay, fine. But what's your basis? Wala lang. Maybe 5 is a nice number. Maybe we need to do it a little bit. Maybe we can consult the accountant, the person in charge, the cashier. Hello, cashier. How's our finances? Well, we're doing fine. But I noticed that per classroom, there are always 5 or 7 empty chairs. But we're paying the same amount to the teacher, whether it's full or not. But the empty chairs, maybe we can fill it up with some scholars. So you analyze, let's see. That's good data. You analyze it. Will the school get bankrupt if we put in some scholars there? Not really. Especially if we welcome the valedictorians in other universities, maybe that will, they will even enhance the discussion. Yeah, that's good. This is a good idea. Let's do it. Let's campaign. Okay. So, ganun ka simple lang. And yet, the you can see not too many people follow this the logic. Why? Some people have many experiences, but they don't analyze the experience. They don't do something. Okay, siguro ito na yung kaloob ng Diyos sa akin. Ito naman siguro ang ako destino, gulong ng pala, pobre me, pero siguro, hindi naman kukuto. So they have plenty of experiences, pains, etc. But they don't analyze the situation. They don't check why they are experiencing this poverty. They don't say this is unchristian, this is unconstitutional, this is untenable, this is etc. etc. And they just survive. Some people gather data and then they analyze. They become professors. And they have good PowerPoint presentations. and you invite them to go to Congress. And I'm just a teacher. Some people are activists. They will go to the poor. They analyze the situation. And then they get angry. And then they engage. They hold guns. And then try to kill as many. well, that's a caricature of man. Pero yung iba, ano lang, galing sa analysis, diretso sa action, may kulang. Sasabihin, Father, pagpapatayin natin lahat ng korang. That's an action based on analysis. Pero, walang reflection na, is that Christian? Kung maubos mo na yung bala mo, naubos mo na yung korang. At kung hindi nagbago ang sitwasyon, sasabihin, well, ginawa ko rin yung tama, yung gusto ko kailangan ko eh. Yeah, pero you don't have hope, you don't have patience, you can be very cruel as a matter of fact. Yung iba, basta babaguhin ang sitwasyon, tapos pag hindi nagbago, mag-abroad. No patience, no charity, no compassion, simple retaliation or justice. Ito marami. Some people go to an area for exposure, and then they skip the analysis. They go straight to the prayer room with dim light effects. Or P.O.P.O. Lord, I can see your face in the face of the poor. And I'll collect a Christmas package right now. But all these years, you know, Christmas package with the poor, nothing has really changed. No structural analysis, no economic analysis. Sabi, pinapahirap ko naman buhay namin, Father. Well, medyo ganyan nga yan. Medyo mahirap niya. Kaya yung iba, huwag nila. Pero tingin ko, practice lang. Sana yun lang. Okay? Now, mag-practice tayo ngayon kaunti-unti. Halimbawa, may bullying. Example, there's bullying. Let's say, meron isang case. Then you gather the teachers. Have you noticed other cases of bullying?
Yes.
You consult the guards, the security guards. Have you noticed the bullying done by teachers or by classmates, elder years to younger years? Then maybe the security guards will give you information. Simply. O kaya ano, yung mga yaya na naghihintay sa labas. For all you know, some of them might be good mathematicians. time.
You will be surprised.
I think Dumaguete in Siliman developed a good program for the Yayas, the nannies. Siliman University is big, so it needs a lot of floor maps. So what they did with those who accompany the drivers, the nannies, they offer them an income generating project. They produce the mops that are used by the university. They have additional income. They have to wait, let's say 3 hours a day or 2 hours a day. 2 hours, they can do something. Even macrame or toiling or whatever. They can do something. So, but you have to analyze what are they good at and what are their desires. Now, in reflection, analysis, it would be good to learn a few tricks like economic analysis, budget analysis, etc. For example, data. Bakit yung mga teachers baon sa utang? Yan. Utang ng utang, makatikista. Sino dito ang baon sa utang? Maraming utang. Kung gumuutang, pabayad sa utang. Diba? Maraming loans. Bakit ganyan? I don't know, but you can analyze. Yung pala, hindi marunong ng savings. Yung pala ang concept, savings is what is left after I spend. Ay, baliktad pala dapat, no? Savings is what you secure before spending. Oh, ganun pala yun. Ay, pala. Kaya naman pala. So, kaya pala, nagkakabon pa sa utang. Cultural pala, cultural, etc. So, anong action? Let's invite somebody who can give budget management, personal financial management. So, tingnan natin, baka mabawasan yung utang. Meron pa savings. Sabi, pupunta sa mall. May listahan, kitchen knives, bibili. Pag-uwi, kung ano-anong sale ang nabili. Kasi sale, sayang. Hindi, pero kailangan mo kitchen knife. Kahit walang sale, yun ang kailangan mo. Eh kaya pagpunta mo sa mall, sale. Pag-uwi mo, ang dala mo, sale. Pero, may everything. You don't really need them, right? Yung pala, ano yung habit o culture? Cultural habits. So sabi mo, ay, hindi maganda yan. Hindi maganda yan. Hindi tama yan. So this portion is not just analysis, but you really make a reflection and a judgment. That is not good. That is not helpful. That is not Christian. That is not legal. That's not legal. Sabi mo, data. May rebate doon sa delivery ng textbook o kaya yearbook, saan na pala napupunta yun? Ano bang system? Kaya pala na ibubulsa? Eh, hindi pala malinaw. Wala palang policy. Who is going to receive the gifts? Who is going to receive the rebates? Wala yan sa resibo. Rebate niya eh. Ay, wala pala. Kaya pala. So, ang mali pala administration. Wala kasing policy. Mali. So, maglagay ng policy. By the way, in one of my chapters here, good schools, bad governance. Good schools, bad governance. The school system is part of the corruption. And as an excursus, I included here the code of ethics for business transactions of schools. And it defines what is a gift, what is a rebate, who can receive gifts, who can receive rebates, and how do we deal with suppliers, how do we deal with parents, especially those who want to become Parents Teachers Association officials, so that they can order purchases. So, meron pa lang ganun. Okay? Now, ang maganda lang dito, kung kompleto. Data, experiences, observation, stories, statistics, analysis, techniques in analyzing, economic analysis, political analysis, budget analysis, policy analysis, reflection, meaning, judgment. You can use norms to make a decision. Halimbawa, cultural norms that hindi yan maka-Pilipino. Or law that's not legal, that's unconstitutional. Or religious faith, that's unchristian. That's not in the spirit of the Beatitudes. Or, pagdating naman dito, engagement action, individual, like group, or institutional action, it starts with planning, implementation, evaluation, and don't forget, celebration. Ngayon, ano yung ano ko dito, analogy ko? Sino man nagpapamasahe sa akin? Sino nagpapamasahe? Okay. Now, ngayon, kailangan ko ng langis. May 10 hektarya ako ng yun. Meron na ba akong langis? Wala pa. Ang gagawin? Kopra. Ano doon yung kopra? Ano yun? Yun. Kasi ano yan? Bagsak. Pag bumagsak na yung yun, may langis na ba ako?
Wala pa.
Ano ang process?
Bibiyakin.
Natalo ba nun na? Bubunutan nun na? Pag nabunutan na, may langis na ba ako?
Wala pa.
Di ba? Oo, no? Pero wala pa ako na eh. Bibiyakin. Pag nabiyak na, may langis na ba ako? Oo, pumunod ko rin. Kaguron ba? Kaguron? Pag na-kud-kud na yung yun, may langis na ba ako? Wala. Bibigayin mo. Pag nabiga, may gata. May langis na ba ako?
Wala.
Pag kumukulo na yung langis, pwede na ako magpamasahe?
Malalamigin.
Malalamigin mo ba? Kasi pag kumukulo na, malalamigin mo ba?
Kumukulo pa eh.
Pag malamig na, pwede na.
Lalagay mo sa bote.
Lagay mo sa bote. Tapos, napabibisyon mo sa bahay. Yamiyaman mo sa bahay. Ibig sabihin, hindi porke may 10 hektarya ka ng karanasan. Eh, garantisado na natama yung gagawin mo. Hindi. Meron mga matanda na parang walang pinagkatandaan. Correct. Pag in the twilight of their years, these people would just sit on the rocking chair. Tatamo-tamo. Sa lumang tumba-tumba, tapos iiling-iling na parang lumang ventilador. At nagsasabi habang tumatanong sa bintana, sayang.
Sayang?
I could have done better. I should have analyzed my experiences and made a firm judgment. Without that judgment, I will not have a very clear plan. Yung bang di mo alam, o nga eh, ang daming patayan, so anong gagawin? Hindi makadesisyon, mali yun eh. Kaya hindi doon may makagawa rin ng aksyon. Dahil hindi ka umabot doon sa mali yan, tama yan, makatarungan yan, hindi yan makatarungan. Eh, hindi rin makagawa ng aksyon. Okay? So that's, basically. Okay? So, parang ganito yan. Module 1, the highlight main data. Yeah. But I'd like to call your attention to the handout that I made. The handout that I made on there, if you notice, that module 1 has two parts. Every module has two parts actually. And yeah. Society and the self. Because this is a part of data Now, take note. Data means observation. Your observation could be about the world or about yourself. Diba, nagpunta ka doon sa mayamang. So that's data. Tapos, sabi mo, mayata. Wow, mga florera ang mahalin nito. That's data. Okay, yan yung nakita mo. O kaya, umating ka ng party ng mga mayayaman. Grabe pagkain. Hindi lang nakakita ng ganitong pagkain. Pati napkin. Printed talaga. Mabulaklak. Ayoko ito, mihal. There's a separate glass for white wine. Another glass for red wine. Oh my God. So, three types of fork and three types of knives. Okay. Yeah. That is your observation of what's happening around you in society. Now, the other aspect is you also observe what's happening to you. How do I feel being with